Hello, happy site owners. Welcome to the Blog A Tips Tuesday video recap. I've got wrap up on all the news for this week, plus some breaking news and different things that you're going to want to know. So let's dive straight into it. Alrighty, so I'm going to get my little iPad thing uppy thing in, so make sure that I can see your comments as they come in, because it's just so much easier than trying to watch them on the screen. And so let me get that one up. I can see that I am transmitting. So there it is, and turn the volume down. And there we go. Woo! All right, so let's jump in, because we got bunches of fun stuff to talk about this week. First thing up is the new, let me get down here to it, in the Blockade Happenings webinar series that I've got coming up this week. Woohoo! I can't wait to get this started. We're going to be doing three in a row every Thursday for the next 3 weeks. And the very first one is this Thursday, August 17th, and it's going to be on WHM hosting accounts. Because if you own multiple sites, or you're a designer or trainer, has set up little sandbox sites for your client projects, or you're a webmaster and you maintain sites for clients who have multiple sites all in one cPanel. That's a super bad idea. That went out in 2013. Need to get over on a WHM account. These things are called reseller accounts commonly. And you know, you don't have to be a reseller to have it. I've got one and I don't resell hosting. I've just got a bunch of sites, right? Besides Blogate, I've got my membership sites, my carving site, my book site, and then I have to set up sandbox sites for my clients to train on as well. And boy, I tell you, this thing is a dream. And so what we're going to do is start out with a tour. You get to see what a WHM account is, what it can do for you. We're actually going to log into an account and let you see what's going on with that. And I've got a special guest for you to tell you the difference between a reseller account on shared and a reseller account on VPS, so you can pick the best fit for yourself. And then next week, we're going to do another one digging into how to set up those cPanel accounts for sites. Oh, designers, you are going to love this. You will not believe how easy it is to set up sandbox sites and delete them just like that, besides whatever else you may be going through to get that done. It's just, oh, it's a thing of beauty, and it's a must-have, because it all hinges on security and performance for your sites, and having them all in one cPanel, that's a horrible bad idea. And then the next one we're going to do is August 31st, and this is only going to be for my webmasters. I'm going to show you how to split sites, because WHM has all the tools in there for you to be able to do that, make it easy if you migrate somebody into one of these WHM accounts to split out their add-on and subdomains into their own cPanels. I'm actually going to do one for you live, right? So check out this post for all the details on it and the registration links. You got to register to get into these webinars so you get the replays and my free gifts for you as well in there. So check out that post for everything that's going on with that. And oh, we've had a bunch of people already sign up. I'm thrilled about it. Hi, Marilyn. Glad to see you here today. Okay, so I want to bring you up to date about my site revamp projects that are coming up, because that's how this WHM webinar came to be in the first place. One of my clients was over on Bluehost, and they had three sites. And we said, well, first, we need to get you off Bluehost, period, right? And now we need to split up your sites into cPanels. And they moved over to new hosting, and I split those sites up, and I told my webmasters about it, and they went, woohoo, man, we want to know how to do that. And so that's how those webinars happened in the first place, you know. So my clients are infinitely more secure. Their sites are performing like lightning now. They're just thrilled about this. We got all that Bluehost junk out of there, and so they're so happy about it. So that's what's going on with some of my clients. And I've also got HTTPS conversions this week. That same client with those three sites, we're about to convert every one of them to HTTPS. We just upgraded to PHP 7, and now we're going to do the HTTPS. So, I mean, we're getting that foundation just trucking right along. And I'm thrilled for one of my clients that we did her conversion today. She moved off InMotion Hosting. You know, they don't even offer free SSL certificates. And none of the EIG-owned hosts do either, Bluehost, HostGator. You talk about being behind the times. Woo! You know, and so we moved her over to A2. We just got her site converted today. It went pretty fast. We had two or three things we had to catch. And, you know, we catch all kinds of things in these conversions as well. People find out their contact forms don't work, or they've got something on there they forgot about, or whatever. And doing an HTTPS conversion pretty much catches all that kind of stuff, too. So we cleaned up some stuff while we were at it, but it went pretty quick. And then later tonight, we're going to, after everything settles down, she just let me know that everything is fine with the site. Then we're going to update all of her Google connections. She's already updated her social media. We're going to put all of the security headers in that Google requires. Now, you know, when you get that free HTTPS conversion, none of that happens. You know, it's a duct tape and chicken wire. They don't actually convert your site. It's just the whole thing is put together with duct tape and chicken wire. This is done right, moved off her plate. Woohoo! And so I'm thrilled about that too. So, you know, that's one of the things I talk about in here is whether your host even offers a free SSL option like Let's Encrypt. You need to check on that and see if they do and make some plans if they don't. And guys, these are things you've got to get off your plate. I'm jumping up and down to tell you because other stuff is coming quickly, and I'm going to tell you about that too. But these are the site foundation upgrades that you need to get off your plate before the end of the year. Hey, you hearing me? Everybody hearing me? I know I'm getting cut off here on the side and cut off my arms. But I got to go big and tell you because I want you to jump up and down. I want everybody to turn the sound down because sometimes these things play silently. And I want to make sure people are seeing what I'm jumping up and down about here. This is so radically important. I told everybody 2 years ago, I told people we're going to hit this perfect storm of all this stuff needing to be done. People blew me off. They didn't listen, whatever. And I've been like screaming in the wilderness all by myself and whatever. I am so proud of my site owners who have been listening and moving these things off their plate. And I'll show you something else. I'm going to scroll back up here right quick. Here. No, not there. Oh, there's one in here somewhere. There it is. The future of WordPress site ownership. Oh, that's behind me, isn't it? Okay, there it is. In the sidebar, look for this. The future of WordPress site ownership. I did this in like January, okay? And trying to scream and yell and tell everybody, hey, you got to get this stuff done. Top of your list now. And I'm going to go back down to the post. PHP 7. This is not a choice. You cannot put this on ignore. It has to be done. I've got a whole PHP 7 challenge for you to do, you know, to find your old plugins, all the stuff that might break and whatever. One of my clients today, we're going to have to migrate her to a new server. She's still staying with her same host, but it's at PHP 5.2. That puts everything at a security risk, right? And she can't even go up to even 5.6, which is a very stable PHP release, much less 7. She has to move to another server on that same host. And that's just like migrating a site to a new host. I mean, there's a lot to it, so I'm helping her with that. So, because we tried to put in a backup plugin, couldn't even run it. The PHP level was so low. That's what you're going to start running into. Broken plugins, broken themes, okay? If you're on an older version of PHP, this is not optional. I know most of us who have owned sites for years have never considered what PHP version we're on. Not optional to put it on ignore anymore. This is something you must do. And you can look on Blogate. I'm going to go, and I probably should have put it in there. I'm just going to go out to do a Google search and do Blogate Serious. Seriously, if you Google Blogate Seriously, you're going to come up with this. The Seriously Old Plugin Challenge. Google that. You'll find it. And I'll go back in Tips Tuesday and put the link. But what this is going to do, it's part of a whole series of things on how to do the PHP 7 compatibility checker. I make it so simple for you to do this for yourself. Okay, it takes just a little while. Go through your plugins, make sure nothing's going to break. Go through and look at your theme, make sure nothing's going to break. Little plugin to help you check that kind of stuff. Get this done. Get it off your plate. All right, next thing is HTTPS. Need to get this done and get it moved off your plate. Again, it's becoming not optional. Right now it's optional and it's not going to stay that way. It's not only Google beating the drum on this. The whole internet is beating the drum on PHP 7 and HTTPS. Okay, Google's going to start requiring this kind of stuff. It already does, partially. Plugin developers, theme developers, hosts, everybody's going to start requiring this stuff, and you don't want to put this off. So get ahead of the curve, get it on your to-do list, and get it done before the end of the year. And here's why. WordPress is about to turn on its head. Okay, You want to get all this other foundational stuff done, because the minute Gutenberg hits, you're going to be pulling your hair out and screaming. Remember when that text editor, that rich text editor widget thingy hit in WordPress 4.8? If you thought that was chaos, wait until Gutenberg hits. It's the new text editor. This WordPress is going to change radically, drastically. And this is the beginning of it. Okay? And I've been telling you about Gutenberg, but they're talking about releasing it maybe as early as January. That's 6 months, guys. 6 months. So you got a lot of stuff that I've been jumping up and down about for 2 years. Definitely all this year telling you, please get this stuff off your plate so that you'll be ready for next when it hits too. Because you don't want to even try to overwhelm yourself with the expense and the stress and whatever, doing all this stuff under duress, right? Or I'm going to be overloaded. You'll wait 2 or 3 or 4 weeks to get on my schedule because people wait till they're in pain. Smart people are doing it now, okay? So, all right. So, I'm going to get off my bandwagon about that, but I'm so thrilled. I'm so thrilled. I can't wait for this. This has been such an exciting project. One of my clients is in the Scratch to Publish class. She came to me for a site audit, and we got to talking about what she really does. You know, she was in this niche, and she actually does something else for a living, and that's where her heart is. And she ended up building a whole new site for that because we found the money in it like crazy. And she got on fire because she knows this stuff, you know, right off the top of your head, right about what you know. And she did. And she has been on absolute fire with the whole thing ever since. And I'm so thrilled. It's been such an exciting project. And they just finished up with her design. I mean, it is, oh, it's great. And it costs so little to get it done because of what she did with it. I can't wait to tell you about this. We're going to be launching it tomorrow. And I know that she is going to make money right away. All of her SEO is right. Everything on it's right. It's going to launch perfect. Her content is there. The SEO is there. The conversion points are there. She's on fire with it. Her editorial blogging calendar is filled for months, like 6 months. I mean, she could post every day for the next 6 months right now. And every single post has a purpose to drive traffic to her site and drive them through her CTAs. It is a thing of beauty. I cannot wait to share this with you. So be looking for that. Okay, so let's jump into that. That's what's happening around blogging. Let's jump into this week's tips. WordPress 4.9, you know, they started immediately right after they released 4.8.1. They started work on this. It was in early August. And they published what the goals are going to be for this. And I think as it stands right now, most of the stuff is in the background. You know, it's about how to, the interface used to edit your code for your themes and plugins. Okay, most of us don't need to touch it. If you are touching it, you probably don't need to touch it, you know. And so this is going to affect designers and developers mainly. But most of the stuff is on the backside. Now, the other thing that they're doing is still working on the customizer because all these changes to the editor and all these changes to the customizer are to get ready for Gutenberg, the new text editor that's coming. But from what I saw, I'm watching the track ticket closely, but from what I saw, I don't think we're going to have a bunch of hoo-ha with this one like we did with 4.8 and 4.8.1, okay? So I'll keep you posted on that, but it's slated for early November at this point. So I'll keep you up to date on that. Now, as I mentioned earlier, Gutenberg is slated for January 2018. Guys, it's 6 months away. And it's like a drag and drop builder. Everything you do for making a post is going to change. When you create a page post, the entire text editor, it's not like Tiny MCE that we're doing now at all. It's more like a blocks of a drag and drop kind of thing. You're going to have to relearn everything. I am not kidding when I said WordPress is turning on its head. Okay. And so I'm watching this very closely now. This date for January all hinges on how the merge proposal goes in December. And that hinges on what comes out in 4.9 in November, right? So we can kind of relax a little bit with the release schedule on this thing. I'll have time to test it out. You know I'm going to put together webinars for you so you can see what's going on with Gutenberg. it's rapid how fast they make changes. I want to give you an idea about this thing. I want to jump over to their weekly report and give you an idea of how fast this thing is being developed. I mean, Matt Mullenweg is cracking the whip on the development. Look at all this, this whole list of changes. This is every week they're doing this. And it's been months of it like that. If it gives you any idea how complex this thing is and how much is going into it, every single week it's going to stay like this until January, and then after that it'll probably keep going. Okay, so just note that I'm keeping up with it, and you keep up with me, and I'm going to keep you on top of this. All right, so let's jump into something a little fun, just total else from WordPress stuff, is for images. I found a bunch of fun things. My favorite Fix-It guy in the whole world, literally, Marcus of Fix My WP, put out this post about how to add watermarks in bulk and on the fly. I am so thrilled about this. I mean, how timely could it possibly be? Let's jump over there and have a look at it. This is fantastic how to do this, because y'all know that I'm working on my carving site. Well, I've got a bunch of old images and I need to put watermarks on all those. Thank you, Marcus. Thank you. I'm thrilled about this. So, and then you can do it on the fly too. Now, I won't necessarily need to do that on the fly for the newer ones, because I'm going ahead and put it in there before I even upload them. But this can do it automatically. It's just going to put them in the, it's going to put it in the same place all the time. Now, for me doing it in bulk, that's perfect. I probably won't be doing it on upload, but isn't it great we have the choice? So I'm thrilled for this. So thank you. Very much, Marcus, for that. How timely. Okay, and then here's one on, I just love food plugins. I love it, love it, love it, love it, love it. And in case y'all haven't seen, let me go over to my, let me scroll back up and go to, whoops, I didn't mean to do that. Let's do it this way, because I want to come back. Obviously, I missed a link when I was doing all that, didn't I? Open a new tab. That's what I meant to do. Let's jump over. This is my carving site. Y'all have heard me talking about it a lot, but I bet you've never seen it. And so, yes, these are my carvings. I got internationally recognized because I did something that everybody said could not be done. They said this would explode. And I said, not if it's engineered properly. Y'all know I'm an engineer. But this is what I'm talking about that I'm working on. And so, you know, just to give you an idea for that. And I've got Foo Gallery plugin all over that carving site. I just love this plugin. I love the interface, love everything about it. And here the guys, and these are great folks, the developers here are great, and they're telling you how to create a responsive image gallery on your WordPress blog using their plugin. And look at this. This is what's so fun about it. Yeah, blah, 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 blah. But they've got links down here to see their gallery template demos and whatever. Ooh, this will give you some ideas about stuff. Wow, Foo guys. Your site's running slow. So anyway, it'll come up here in a second. But it's all about how to do that. So we'll come back to that one when it comes up. But they've also got a post on how to create a responsive video gallery. What did I do? Did I bring up the same one? I did. Okay, here it is. Foo Video Gallery. I'm sorry. Video marketing tips. I got too many links going, don't I? Okay, this is a thing of beauty. I mean, they basically took their image gallery thing and made it for videos. Woo! And I can't wait to do that for my carving site. I'm also going to start doing it on Blogate. I'll probably start doing it for my member site so you can see little titles and those kinds of things. I like that very much. So if you scroll down through here, they show you about their Lightbox that it comes with and all the things that are supported and lets you see the back of it just a little bit. And I thought they had some layout options here for, yeah, here it is. Look at this. Now, what you're seeing here is kind of the same for the image gallery. Oh, you talk about giving you some ideas. Look how pretty this is. And it's got little shadows under there and everything. And then look at this. You could have the titles and an excerpt. Woo! So, I mean, how cool is that? And then, you know, they've got even more. Look at this. You can make little squares of all of them. I mean, this is great. I just love this. So, you know, the price is really good too, $29 for it, and you can get from multiple sites. So really, really huge value on this thing as well. Now, before you get that one, you owe it to yourself to go check out Envira Video Gallery. Same sort of thing, same sort of pricing, and does the same kind of layouts, You may like it better or not, or whatever. It's got drag and drop builder and templates and stuff. Hey, it's good to have choices. Both of these are premium plugins, and so you might want to have a look at that. And then, before you decide, go over and look at this happy tutorial from the folks at WP Beginner. They go over the Envira Gallery. And so this way you get a look at the backside, blah, 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 blah. Here you go. Now you get a look at the backside, what this thing is, before you get it, and a full tutorial from them. So that's kind of sweet too. All right. Now, the last thing that I want to tell you about tonight is how to get notifications when folks go live on Facebook like this. You know, my buddy Krishna Day has the best post. Listen, you need to follow Krishna if you're into video anything, and I hope you are, because video is taking over the world. Every social media platform is promoting video like crazy. If you're not in the game, you need to get in the game. You don't have to do talking head like this. Lots of ways to get into video, but live streaming is very cool. And so Krishna Day here has, I'm going to agree to her cookies for her international stuff because she is in Ireland. So she stays on top of everything, video, everything there is. Krishna is on top of it. I mean, every platform, every app, every piece of software, everything, she is on it. So do follow her, and she's going to show you here how to receive notifications when your faith peeps go live on Facebook. Make sure that you're getting her notifications. Make sure that you're getting the notifications for Blogate as well, right? So when I go live, you can also catch these in replay over on YouTube, and you can subscribe over there when I go live and when I update and upload videos there too. And let me scroll all the way back up the top, and I'm going to show you something. Where is it? Here it is. Subscribe. Oh, that's behind me, isn't it? Here. Let me get totally out of the way a little bit. It's right here above my head on this. It's how to subscribe to the Blogate YouTube channel. There's a little bell you got to click, and so you're subscribed. Now, the great thing about doing that is that you're going to be able to see videos I upload for tutorial posts I'm going to post the next day, so you get a sneak peek. How about that? So you're always ahead of the curve. You always make sure that you get to see those things no matter what happens in the Facebook feed. So that is Tips Tuesday video recap and breaking news. Guys, just please heed me when I say to get these foundational site things upgraded, like PHP 7, HTTPS. You've got to get this stuff done now. Start following me for the Gutenberg stuff, because come the holidays and turn of the year, WordPress going to turn on its head, and you're going to need to be in the know when this happens. You don't want to be in a panic searching for things then. You know I'm going to do stuff to keep you ahead of the curve. All right, that's it for today, and I'll see you online.